$800, like, up front. He has never treated me. Hey guys, so welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Hannah and I upload videos every Monday and Friday. Usually they are beauty videos, but today is a story time video, which I'm sure you can tell by the title. If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Also, feel free to stick around and subscribe and hit the bell notifications. That way you will not miss whenever I upload a video. I just wanna get a little disclaimer aside. I'm no way saying that you should not go to chiropractors, that all chiropractors are like this one that I'm going to tell you about, because personally, I go to a chiropractor and I've gone to a few. So I think that they can be really helpful, and I just wanted to say that just so this doesn't come across wrong. As I said, I just kind of wanna share this story time with you. All that disclaimer information aside, I'm going to tell you about the time that a chiropractor tried to scam me. So this happened over a year ago. Honestly, I'm not sure exactly when because I kind of forgot about it. But then I was driving with my dad the other day and then we drove by this chiropractic office and then that reminded me, oh yeah, I remember that story, and I thought that it would be an interesting video. So a little bit of a backstory before we get into that. I have had a back problem since my freshman year of college, which was 2012. It's been a little while. It's not from like an accident or anything like that. Honestly, I think it's mostly hereditary. My back just kind of flares up every now and then. And honestly, at its worst, like, I don't want to like make it seem like it's at the end of the world, but also it is pretty painful. Just that's something that I go through, because at its worst, it does get really difficult to walk and it can be really painful there for like a week or two. So it is kind of a chronic issue that I've gone through for a while now. I found a chiropractor that I really liked, and honestly, it's like one of the best chiropractors that I've gone to so far. He was really helping me, but then he wasn't going to be covered in my insurance anymore, it seemed like, so I needed to find another chiropractor. And I waited, of course, until I was in excruciating pain and before I tried to find another chiropractor. So my mom had gone to this chiropractor, this one that I'm going to tell this story about. She had gone to him for a little while, so she recommended me to him because he had helped her out. But whenever I went to that office, it was a different chiropractor. So it was the same office, but different chiropractor, which was kind of unfortunate. But we were already there, already had an appointment, just kind of went through with that. Also, I do like to go with somebody whenever I'm going to make like a medical decision. Usually it's my mother. Like, yes, I'm an adult and can make decisions myself, but if I'm about to spend a lot of money or just make like a decision like that, I kind of want someone to help me make the decision or see what their thoughts are on it. And also, my mom is obviously older than me and wiser, just saying that as well. She was there with me for the appointment, but he wanted to, so the first thing, this isn't the scam, but this is just like the first part of the story. The first thing, he would not treat me until I got x-rays, and I've been to a different chiropractor and I kind of understand that, but I had x-rays that were fairly recent, but he refused to accept those. So I had to get x-rays done. Also, that cost was out of pocket. Thankfully, my parents paid for that. Honestly, like, I'm so thankful, because I think it was over $100 or something like that. So he wouldn't even treat me. Like, I'm in excruciating pain. He would not even treat me until I got an x-ray. And then obviously he had to review it. So I had to schedule another appointment to see him. So I did that. But the next available appointment, my mom was working, so she wasn't able to go with me, but I was in like such bad pain that, you know, like, I was like, oh, that's fine. Like, I can do this kind of thing, or I don't know, whatever. Regardless, my mom was not able to go with me to my next appointment. Also, another thing that I wanted to say is I know that chiropractors treat differently. Some of them require an exam, like a general exam, to kind of see where your baseline is, like your range of motion and that kind of thing. So I'm aware of that, but honestly, I can't remember if he required that as well. Like, I feel like he might have, but I can't 100% remember, so I'm not gonna say that he did. So I'm aware of that situation, but like, he wouldn't even accept my x-rays, which was kind of annoying. So for my next appointment, which, remember, I'm by myself in excruciating pain, for my next appointment, he goes through my x-rays and kind of talks about the problems with my back and then different treatment plans, or different phases of improvement. We'll go with that kind of phrase. So he was like showing me my x-rays and also writing down the different phases of treatment. Then he got into talking about the cost. There were a couple of different payment options, and if I were to pay individually, like per treatment rather than paying up front, it was going to end up being like $900. $900. That's with insurance. I was gonna have to pay $900. I will say, you know, like I mentioned, my parents paid for my x-ray, so I was really thankful for that, but I was going to be the one paying for my chiropractic health. Also, keep in mind, he has still not not treated me, so I had no idea like how his treatment, anything like that, but I would be like, I think it was a, I don't know if it was a contract, but I think I was still going to be like tied into spending that $900 whenever he hasn't even adjusted my back. So I had no idea if it was gonna help me. So that was treatment option number one. Let's keep that in mind. Or I could go with treatment option number two and pay all up front in a lump sum with insurance. You know, that's the insurance cost. And I could pay all that up front and spend $800. $800 like up front. He has never treated me, and I know I talked like I called this a scam at the beginning, and I'm kind of getting upset again. Maybe this is why I kind of like honestly blocked this out of my mind, but to me that kind of is somewhat of a scam, or I don't know what you want to call this, but he wanted me to pay $800 up front. He's just like, I was like 22 23, like I'm a child still, like let's be real, like I can't, like that is just so much money to spend. So anyway, I don't know if he was thinking that I was going to make a decision right then and there. Like, yeah, sure. Let me go get my checkbook and sign a check to you for $800. Like, nah, fam. I don't know what he was thinking. But okay, so after he gave me all of this treatment option, he still was not going to treat me. I was still in excruciating pain. He has not helped me out at all. All he's done is really stressed me out with like how much money that I'm gonna have to spend, and has not treated me. Like, I'm in excruciating pain, you guys. So I did finally like convince him, I guess, to treat me. Like, he's like, well, I typically didn't want to do this without like having a treatment plan or whatever, but he did basically adjust my back before I left, which honestly, I guess I was thankful for, because I was in such excruciating pain, but like that whole process just was not enjoyable. Anyway, so he adjusted my back, and I think, I don't know if he was like expecting me to come up with a decision right then and there, but I just like straight up told him like, I need to discuss this with my parents. Like, yeah, that's what I did. I left that office that day, and I never came back. So I'm getting a little ahead of myself. I went home and I discussed that with my parents, and they thought it was kind of a weird process too. Right now, I feel like that's obviously like no duh. Like, why would you even contemplate spending $800? But I was in such a bad, like I was in such pain. I've gone through pain like for so many years that can kind of really like affect you overall. And I was just thinking like, I guess I'll do this. But so there for a second, I feel like I was kind of like honestly contemplating spending that much money, but I don't know. Like when I was discussing with my parents, like they thought it was kind of like a weird situation too. And I know that chiropractors are different, but they hadn't heard of anything like that before either. Also, it just, I don't know. Like I know obviously medical professions, like I know they need to make money obviously to keep, stay in business and stuff, but it seemed like his best interest, or what he, like the number one thing he had in mind, was himself making money and not me being relieved of my pain. I don't think I ever called him back. Honestly, I just decided not to go with that option, obviously. He did adjust me, so, and also this has been a while, so I can't totally remember like the sequence of events after that, but I do remember that it turned out that the chiropractor that I had gone to that had been really helpful ended up still being somewhat covered in my insurance, but I just had to, like, it didn't cover it as much, so I still had to pay a little bit more. But I went back to that chiropractor for a little while, and honestly, like, that's probably been one of the most helpful chiropractors that I've gone to. Another thing that I forgot to mention is, with whenever I thought that they weren't going to be covered in my insurance, it was going to be $55 to $65 per visit, and my back was in like a state where I would have to go probably, I'd say, every other week, and I just, like, in the long term, I could not afford that. Thankfully, the other chiropractor was covered in my insurance later on. But that whole process, I mean, I guess it makes for a story. I don't know if some of you would see it as a scam. Like I said, like, I'm not trying to say all chiropractors are like this. I know that they do treat differently, but that's just the way that I took it. And it just was kind of upsetting, because it seems like he was more interested in himself making money than me being out of my pain. So that is my story with that. Thanks again for watching. Also, feel free to stick around and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video.